what you thought?
Thought I was gonna let a little parking discrepancy keep me from my coffee? No, sir. It's the Trooper. Monday, 12:48 in the PM. Uploading the vlog from yesterday. Bam! You see it. 47%? Come on! 13 minutes remaining? Come on! I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go out there and do what? Play it by ear. That's what I do. Play it by ear. Ding ding, ting 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 ticky ticky ting ting. I don't think that's a piano song. Food. Trooper. What? What you gonna eat? I don't know. I know.
Over at the Mirage. It seems like Venetian has all the games. They've got a promotion going on for October. It's $1,000 high hand every hour. Oh shit, I went to the wrong floor. Ground floor. Normally, you go to this floor. Because there's a bridge across. For some reason, my card wouldn't work in the, does September 2018 mean that's when it expires? It wouldn't work in the parking. Gotta check it out. If Pearl is expired and I'm back down to whatever the blue card is, Sapphire? I may have to play some hours to get my parking privileges back. Oh, let's find out. Okay, so apparently on September 30th, my Pearl status expired. So, I gotta figure out how to maintain my Pearl status playing poker. I know that at one point it was 75 hours in one room. Then something changed. I'm not really sure what the details are, and here's the biggest problem. MLive doesn't know, and the poker room here at Mirage doesn't know. Nobody working back there knows anything about how to be Pearl playing poker. You know I refuse to pay for parking. So since it's been less than an hour, less than 1 hour is free, so I gotta change parking spots. You are not going to catch me paying a casino to park, period.
I know what you think of Trooper. Where did I park?
So, I know what you think of Trooper. But you're not gonna play at Mirage. Why shouldn't you be able to park free at Mirage? Because I parked at Cromwell yesterday and I played at Mirage. That's why. Right next door for a little Treasure Island parking. No big deal. The reason I parked at Mirage in the first place was because I wanted to hit the Starbucks in the Forum Shops because I haven't had enough coffee yet today. And I didn't get a coffee on the way because that dude who always screws up my drink was working in there. Oh, I went in. I was like, I'm gonna get me a coffee. And then that dude was working. That dude messes up my coffee every time. You know what I'm talking about, Elijah? Who the hell's Elijah? Elijah? Alicia? How you doing? I realize it says Aniela or something like that. Taking the scenic route today because it's 73 degrees, and if you're in the shade, it's amazing. Indirect sunlight is probably warm. This will find that out in a minute, but right now, all the shade action we got, palm trees and whatnot, it's nice out here. Thank you.
told me the other day that he went to Venetian and it was terrible. And I believe it. But there's a lot more games at Venetian than other places today. There are 13 1-2 games going at Venetian. There's only one at Harrah's. What? And then Caesars has like 7. I'm not in the mood for Caesars, not even a little bit. Plan to play that long today because I have plans to do something else tonight, but I think I can get a few hours in. Let's go see what's going on. Still a little daylight out here. All done with that boring ass game at Venetian. As far as promotions go, $1,000 high hand for that entire room per hour is about the least exciting way to give away that much money. I would much rather see $250 every 15 minutes or something like that, because it creates a lot more buzz and people are more excited. When they were doing the $300 splash pots every 15 minutes, it was a pretty exciting atmosphere in there, and there was the games were actually pretty good for a change at Venetian. The weather out here is unbelievable, and now that the sun is way down over there, it's there's no like direct sunlight beating on the strip. It's really awesome. I wish there was an exciting hand or situation or something from the game that I could tell you about, but there really aren't any. I guess the only interesting note I have from today's session at the poker table is that a dealer came into our game and he, in the last 30 minutes, had dealt the current standing high hand of the hour, which was quad aces. So some guy at some table got quad aces. His hand is on the board as the highest hand. If it doesn't get beat, he's gonna win 1,000. This dealer sits down and says, mentions the fact that he dealt it and that he hopes it holds so that he might get tipped. He actually used the word tipped. Generally, poker dealers would use the term tote, but back to the point. What's the guy saying? He's actually saying to everyone at my table, including me, that he hopes we don't win the high hand. How weird is that? Now, logic would suggest that if he is the dealer of the hand that beats the high hand that he dealt, then he would still get tipped. But that's not what he said. Not only did he say that when he first came into the game, but someone announced over the through the microphone that there were so many minutes left in this high hand, the current high hand is still quad aces, blah blah blah. And when they made that announcement, he said, yeah, keep it that way. The dealer did. So he's saying again that he hopes that the people who he's currently dealing to don't win the high hand. That's just not a good thing to say at all. I won a pot too, and I considered his statement before I toked him. By the way, none of this is a complaint, nor is it, you know, a statement that this dealer's a bad person, or, you know, is really wishing for what he said. What it is, though, is a note to anyone who deals poker. Think about what you're saying, because I almost didn't tip the guy when I won this small pot because of that. When he said that, it rubbed me the wrong way. I was just like, really? I know he didn't mean anything by it. And I did tip him on the pot. I'm just saying, if you're a dealer and you say things like that, there could be people who hear you, and then it may cost you. It really may cost you. Imagine that some guy who's like really kind of jerky, not like me, like play funny jerky, but really jerky. Imagine a guy like that were to win the high hand during the half hour that he was dealing my table. Imagine some guy on the other side of the table is really grumpy, doesn't like to tip anyway, normally would, but because this guy said what he said, what if that guy hit the high hand and won the $1,000? And then not only would the dealer's high hand have gotten beaten, but the good news would have been that he dealt it to beat himself, and then he got stiffed. Imagine, I'm just saying, imagine it. If you're a poker dealer, I'm trying to help you out. That's all I'm trying. I'm trying to help you out. Yo, I'm gonna head on out of here. This is the end of the day. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. Trying to get back into the groove. Yo, I'll see you next time.